Hi, in this video, I'm going to give you a brief idea how to set up a solar panel system to power up the Wi-Fi fiberbox camera. First, let's take a look at what we need. We'll need to have this battery. It's quite easy to understand. We'll use the battery to save the energy so it can power the camera at night. More importantly, we cannot connect the solar panel directly to the Wi-Fi fiberbox camera. The voltage output from the solar panel gets about up to 18 watts. But the camera only can take in the 12 watt voltage. The voltage from the camera is too high, which may damage the camera. Then can we connect the solar panel directly to this battery to charge the battery? Also negative. You see, there's need to have the charger to control the charging process. Otherwise, even the battery is full, the solar panel may still provide the power. Eventually, it may fire up the battery. It's quite dangerous. So we need to have this charger. Solar panel charger. You connect the solar panel to the input of the solar panel charger, and the power will go to the charger. And we'll connect the battery to the output, so it will just get the energy from the solar panel and charging this battery. It will detect if the voltage is enough, it will stop the charging, even you have the power from the solar panel. And there's one output, this output will connect to the camera. So eventually, the charger will supply the power to the camera. And there's also, the charger has the voltage regulator built-in. Even the power, the voltage is 12, it's over 12 volts. It will just regulate the power and supply the status output to the camera. So there's several mistakes people may make. Eventually you could damage the camera. The first thing is make sure the positive negative is right. From this cable, we can see the positive and negative. So if you just mix up the positive and negative, it will damage the camera eventually. The safe way is you can using the power meter to measure the output. From this output, make sure the positive is right, the negative is right. And the second thing is we saw some of the customers, they just order the solar panel. And with the charger built-in, this small charger, I think it's not the professional charger, then they connect the solar panel with the charger to the battery directly. That's fine because it can charge the battery. But the mistake he made is he connected the camera from this battery. You know, in the charging process, the voltage will be the same. Like what we mentioned, with the charger, we have a power regulator. But if you just connect the camera to the battery at the same weight, the voltage will be high because there's no voltage regulator to power the camera. So in that kind of solution, I think it's very dangerous if you just connect the battery to the camera directly. When will you charge? It will pull up the voltage because the solar panel. So the voltage will become very high, up to 18 volts. And the camera, you're getting the 18 volts, so eventually damage. That's another thing. Also, the customer asking, can we use this small solar panel? It work, but it just work for a few hours. So it's not enough power to supply the power for the camera. Basically, what I recommend is for the battery, you can use this motorcycle battery, 20 amp hour, 12 voltage. That will be enough, like this one. For the solar panel, you may need like 60 watt. You can reference the link at the down below. I just post the link about what is the recommendation specification for the solar panel system. Okay, just one last thing. If you think this is too complicated, such like using solar panel, also charger, the battery, actually we can remove the solar panel and the charger. Just use the battery to power the camera. It's quite simple. If we just use the battery to power the camera, then you don't need to worry about the charging anything, because when the batteries run out, you can take this battery and recharge it, or you can get two batteries, just swap after the battery run out. This solution is quite simple. Only thing is you need to swap or recharge the battery in-house. All right, that's all for today's video. If you have any question, please post comment section below. See you next time.